Welcome to Take the Lead Radio with Dr. Diane Hamilton, where she interviews some of the most successful leaders, entrepreneurs, authors, speakers, and other individuals who will inspire you to take the lead in your career and personal life. And now, here is Dr. Diane Hamilton.
Welcome to Take the Lead Radio. This is Dr. Diane Hamilton, and I'm so glad you joined us today because we have Vladimer Botsvadze here. Vladimer is a globally renowned speaker, digital transformation, and social media influencer. He has a lot to say about social media and how to be a success. So we are going to talk to him, and we're going to do that right after this.
Are you interested in finding out more about how HR professionals or leadership consultants can become certified to give the groundbreaking new Curiosity Code Index assessment? The certification program will provide the ability to administer the assessment at reduced rates. Participants will learn how to interpret the results of the CCI, as well as how to deliver an innovation plan workshop designed to improve curiosity, engagement, innovation, and productivity. To find out more, go to curiositycode.com.
I am here with Vladimer Botsvadze, who is a globally renowned, multi-award-winning digital transformation and social media influencer, Fortune 500 consultant, thought leader, professor, keynote speaker, and media personality. He's ranked number one by Thinkers 360. You've seen him everywhere. It's so nice to have you here, Vladimer.
Thank you. Hello, Diane, and thanks for inviting me to your podcast episode. And I'm delighted to share my expertise with your show.
Well, I am excited to have you here. And you have quite a background of, I mean, you've won so many awards. That was just one I listed. And I think what you're working on is just amazing. I think it would help, though, for people to get a background on you. Do you mind just telling us a bit about how you reached this level of success?
Yes. Diana, I am a top social media and digital transformation influencer, professor, and startup advisor with more than 14 years of international experience in marketing and innovation, with a proven track record providing guidance to executives and top brands worldwide. I am renowned for my work as a tireless brand builder, and I use my experience to motivate my audience. I'm honored to be ranked number one marketing, innovation, retail, sales, supply chain thought leader by Thinkers 360. I'm also ranked number two global retail influencer by Global Data. Now, I'm also proud to be among top five global B2B thought leaders by Thinkers 360 alongside Brian Solis, Marsha Collier, Evan Kistel, and other top influencers. Overall, I won over 200 awards in digital transformation innovation. Millions of people around the world recognize my inspirational insights, and millionaire entrepreneurs seek my advice and my presentations, masterclasses, and online publications turn managers into practitioners. I am frequently invited to top global business schools, summits, podcast episodes, and corporate meetings to deliver my talks. And I'm recognized for my leadership and trailblazing innovation through my consulting, speaking, teaching, and mentoring services. Companies have grown from a groundbreaking idea into the fastest growing companies. For example, my expertise is trusted by London Business School, Forbes, Economist, Audi, and other global brands. I do utmost every single day to help the entire world achieve more. I have been praised by Intel, other Fortune 500 brands for my experience, track record, and professionalism. My clients accomplished record-breaking success. I have been interviewed by TV channels and radio shows and top podcast episodes on topics related to social media marketing and innovation. I'm always driven to inspire audiences to reach new heights, think forward, and solve marketing problems. And when I moved to the United States at the age of 18, I knew from the first second that I was going to move up in the world and go places. I have worked hard and smart on myself. I have been disciplined and driven everywhere. I demand ultimate results from myself every single day, and I'm lucky to live in the best era of history when I can achieve so much through social media platforms, which I use every day for professional purposes. I agree with James Clear, who said that It has never been a better time for self-motivated people. Anyone connected to the internet has an education of a university and the distribution power of a media company and their fingertips. And curiosity, courage, and persistence are the new gatekeepers. I worked and lived at the age of 18 in New York and Washington, and I worked and studied at the age of 22 in London. Also, I worked at the age of 27 in Dubai. I became obsessed with growth in business and tech, and I'm passionate about what I do that positively impacts 40 million individuals annually. I'm proud of my efforts, which show that through hard work and persistence, everything is possible. It is in my DNA to work outside my comfort zone by going for my dreams, exploring new things, and getting the most out of my life. And I have risen to global prominence since I became a top influencer across multiple social media platforms, including Twitter, 57,000 followers, LinkedIn, over 24,000, and Instagram, over 10,000 followers, with a total of 125,000 followers from over 1,000 cities and 185 countries. I have been recommended by London Business School, KPMG, MasterCard, AC Milan, Forrester Research, PepsiCo, and other leading global brands. And I enjoy helping others succeed online, and I'm on a mission to make a difference and impact as many business owners as possible. I help corporations with strategies that drive and grow.
Well, it sounds like, do you sleep? I mean, it sounds like you're doing a lot of
yes,
work.
Yes, absolutely. And Diane, yes, I'm very committed to providing value and helping other brands triple and quadruple their results. And I'm very, very committed, very dedicated. And as you can see, I have sacrificed so much, you know, in the last 10 years. And I have said no to many social activities in order to grow my personal brand, in order to build my business. And you know, it is interesting to see that it cost me $0 to build my Twitter, to build my LinkedIn, to build my personal brand, which allowed me to, to become a speaker with so many great speakers bureaus, like All American Speakers, Champion Speakers UK, Las Vegas Speakers Bureau, and other global brands, which I had not imagined like 10 years ago, you know. So when you work hard and when you are passionate about what you do, you open so many doors in business. And fortunately, our world rewards hardworking and passionate and dedicated people.
Well, it definitely does. And you mentioned that you moved to the U.S. Where did you move here in the U.S.?
I moved to Washington D.C. area. I was 18. I was 18 when I moved to the D.C. and then I had trainings and I got my work permit from the State Department, got my Social Security card. I started working in Manassas in DC area, like 25 minutes away from DC. I worked then like 2-3 months in Manassas as a manager. And then I spent a few months like exploring United States. Like I lived almost 2 months in New York City. And wow. I mean, this period totally transformed my career, my vision. And I started seeing the world like easier, faster, and clearer, which allowed me to be passionate about what I do and to be driven and to be enthusiastic every single day. When I wake up, I'm grateful and I thanks to God that I have energy and drive and motivation to impact lots of people worldwide and to make my dreams come true, you know?
Well, that's really inspirational, and you got into an area I think is really interesting. Became an expert in digital transformation.
Yes.
So, what made you interested in going that direction?
Success. You know, success is like an iceberg. You know, people only see tiny part, but what really happened? It is a desire, passion, focus, effort, late nights, patience, spirit, perseverance, and without these qualities, I would not stand where I do today. And in 2014, you know, I connected with Glenn Gilmore on Twitter. You know, who mm-hmm. inspired me to build my personal brand. And he helped me to connect with entire tech audience through Twitter. Then I started putting out content on Twitter, and I became very enthusiastic about growing my personal audience. And then I connected with many trade associations with all media companies and everyone through Twitter, you know. And you know, my hard work on Twitter truly moved mountains, you know. If someone Googles me, and they will see everything I achieved, like my interviews, my Speakers Bureau memberships, my awards, my contribution to digital transformation industry's growth, you know. So it is I'm always happy, you know. I my optimism, positivity, patience drive my results. It's also about making yourself better every single day. I spend a couple of hours reading management, marketing, business leadership books. Jim Rohn said that formal education will make you a living, and self-education will make you a fortune, you know. And self-education is everyone's responsibility in this decade, and it is duty for every modern professional, you know, because what you study at a business school is not enough. It is a drop in the ocean, and you have to be constantly outside your comfort zone to expand your horizon and learn daily what's happening in your industry, because a lot changes. And if you don't learn a lot, and if you don't put out content across 8-10 social networks, right, you get left behind. So I mean, to stay relevant in the age of digital transformation and disruption, right, you need to learn daily and to be committed to providing value. Also, soft skills also play a big part in my success, that include leadership. I'm able to lead, inspire my colleagues with my insight, experience, innovation, and creativity. I bring new ideas on ways to help the world to be successful. And my strategies in digital transformation technology help top brands maximize their success. My marketing track record is exceptional, which is the reason why so many leading executives trust my expertise, and TV, radio shows, and podcast episodes like to feature my voice. Regardless of my success, I'm a frank person. Audiences love my personality, and they enjoy interacting with me. And I always put helping others first, and I constantly focus on adding value to other people's lives.
Yeah, well, you know, I think you brought up so much right then, and it's so interesting when you talk about the digital transformation, and you said the new ideas you bring. So I want to get a focus on digital transformation for a minute.
Yes.
What areas of digital transformation do you help companies with? And just can you describe what you mean by digital transformation?
Yes, actually, it is mostly the new trends in this decade, which are AI, machine learning, like augmented reality, virtual reality, IoT, big data, fintech, and retail tech, you know. I will start with AI, right? AI is a battleground on which the long-term business success will be decided, and AI-powered organizations are getting ahead. AI technologies learn, understand, express, foresee, develop, and function autonomously, you know. Mm-hmm. AI can develop companies' business models, relationships with customers, and marketing. So I help brands in this area, you know. Also, machine learning is a process, you know, using data to gain experiential intelligence over time, works by understanding information using neural network. It can offer something to every industry, and it can offer to understand consumers like never before. As everyone knows, chatbots are set to revolutionize how customers interact with brands. AR, VR are changing the reality, the way that people perceive and interact with digital world. IoT, from mobile first to mobile only, IoT is going to change the face of mobile device forever. People are able to enjoy enhanced protection for their homes at lower cost. Big data continuously drives business innovations, real-time insights, optimize and boost profits. Fintech, in terms of fintech, consumers now have access to a myriad ways to pay. E-commerce, mobile commerce, and one-click commerce are becoming popular. And last but not least, in digital transformation, retail tech, retailers have to meet expectations of customers who are increasingly shopping on mobile devices. And by targeting and personalized experiences, companies can increase sales.
Well, you know, you bring up some really interesting things. I teach for a lot of different universities here in the United States, and right now I'm teaching a course for technology students, and their job in this course is to create a technology, a service, or a product type of idea that they flesh out a plan by the end of the 5-week course, which is, it's kind of fun to do. And it's really fun to see the creativity that they come up with. And I know that there's chatbots, as you mentioned, and all these different types of things that we're going to see. And I think it's to develop some of this innovation, going back to your self-education discussion, I think that that's why, you know, my expertise is in the area of developing curiosity and soft skills and all the things that you were talking about that fall into that area. How are you helping these companies become more curious to get out of status quo ways, the old ways of doing things?
Yes, it's a very interesting question. Thank you, Diane. Mm-hmm. Actually, you know, what I see nowadays in the business world is that people lack curiosity. People lack interest. People lack enthusiasm in what they do. They think, you know, they can just go to work, earn money and go back to home, and they are uninterested at the end of the day. They rarely put out content. They rarely blog. They rarely share their expertise with everyone outside their company. And I think business schools produce such people, you know, and we lack people who provide value and people who lead by example. And what we should do in order to make people become more curious, you know? Actually, we need more practical technology conferences, you know, to share expertise. For example, what I do, how I achieved everything through Twitter, right? Because because I have put in the work, I sacrificed, I showed interest, I showed curiosity to build relationship with thought leaders, influencers, and to pick brain from other leaders, you know. So I see that people lack enthusiasm and people lack curiosity in technology and innovation, you know. And actually, so many brands went out of business because they believe in strategies existed 20 and 30 years ago. Because I know so many professors, Diane, and you know, sometimes what they teach in 2020 is not relevant, you know, because whatever they teach. It used to work in 1985 and 1995, and they need to, teach contemporary practical marketing strategies. You know, for example, what allowed Gary Vaynerchuk to become big in marketing and innovation and to build multi-million-dollar companies. You know, and anyone can go big nowadays in business without even earning an MBA degree or PhD. You know, And everyone I see nowadays on the list, on the influencers list, thought leaders list, everyone is self-made millionaires and self-made influencers, you know, because they download these Twitter, they put out content, they connected with other people, they built their personal brands, and it costs them $0 to gain ground and go places, you know. It is very interesting perspective, you know, and we need to change the conversation of business world nowadays because you know what I listen sometimes is that, you know, I mean everyone stands a fantastic chance to stand out in 2020, not just to fit in the society and to survive. Anyone can stand out, Diane. You know, I was not born in the United States, I was not born in the UK, but you know, I showed curiosity, I showed interest to move to the United States at the age of 18, which allowed me to open so many doors and to educate myself and expand my horizon. And if anyone sees me in 2020, they see me on the influencers list, they see me, I'm a speaker with speakers bureaus, they see me, I'm a member of chief CMEO council and IoT council, and I'm nominated for the world's best awards. And I'm grateful for every opportunity, Diane. It is a godsend opportunity for me, what I have, whatever is available at my fingertips. And I teach and I inspire and I motivate everyone at top companies, Fortune 500 brands, business schools, trade associations, and in every sector that they need to be more curious, they need to be more interested, they need to be more patient. Because everyone wants success at the drop of a hat, which is impossible, Diane, you know. Because they need to, show more patience, to be more determined, to be more. When I'm connected with top influencers like Gary Vaynerchuk, like Guy Kawasaki, Glenn Gilmore, influential business leaders, I'm so motivated that I can't slow down, you know. And everyone, there were moments in my life when people used to tell me that, come on, Vladimer, don't put out content, don't blog. Why you should do that, you know? And but I never slow down, Diane, you know. I have never taken any vacations, you know. Actually, when you listen to Gary Vaynerchuk and such hustlers, you know that, you know, through putting in the work, you can make all your business come true and you can build incredible businesses. You can become a top professional speaker and you can, I mean, you can move up in the world in every way, And I always believed in putting in the work, connecting with other thought leaders and to putting out more content. And to explore emerging platforms, because everyone knows that that things change like grease lightning in our industry, and you need to stay on top of the game in order to win and to be successful, right, in this decade. So when there is a will, there is a way. People need to be more curious. Absolutely, I agree with you that your focus on curiosity is what leads to success. You know. And if people show more interest, if people show more curiosity, and if they are more bound and determined, they will achieve more than what they have been said at business school to achieve something, you know. Because I have done my master's, I've done my PhD, but whatever I learned outside my comfort zone led to more success, you know. It allowed me to open so many doors. And
I'm curious about that. Your PhD, yes, and, what was your doctoral dissertation? What did you write about?
It was actually about in digital transformation, artificial intelligence. It was about creating of logistic hubs throughout Europe, you know? Uh-huh. And it was about trade and economy, you know? So then I started building my Twitter in 2014 and I completed my PhD in 2013, you know? Mm-hmm. So building my Twitter turned out to be a road to Damascus, you know? And which totally changed my way and transformed my vision. And I started seeing the world faster, easier, clearer. And I'm going to write even more books in the future. And I'm so happy when I wake up and I'm nominated for some of the world's top awards. And London Business School follows me on Twitter and Forbes follows me on Twitter. I'm so happy because I deserve to be followed by top big media companies and to be interviewed globally and to share my practical tips and strategies with everyone that inspires the world to achieve more and to gain a competitive advantage.
Well, you brought up so many interesting points. I want to touch on some of the things you said a few minutes ago about tech conferences and some of the things. And I know when I, you probably run into this with technology students in my courses and tech conferences where I attend, they really love the tech kind of speakers. They want to get into the technology, but I think it's really important that they get into learning the curiosity, the soft skills and some of that stuff. And I think that what's interesting, when I worked as MBA program chair at the Forbes School of Business, I created a brand publishing course about marketing and different things for CMOs with Forbes and all that, to talk about some of the marketing strategies that you were talking about. And I think that a lot of people are very confused by all the choices for vendors and how to reach their followers or whatever with their brands. They just have a really tough time knowing where, how to publish content in meaningful ways that reaches people on a individual basis, but at scale. So I think that some of the things you're talking about, I think it's really challenging. You talk a lot about Twitter and some of the social media that's available, but do you think that they're also struggling with all the other vendors? Of how to get messages out and how to have content calendars and all the things that you have to do to get your products to be recognized by your consumers?
Diane, we experienced that so many brands went out of business, like Blockbuster, right, and like other brands, because they believed in strategies that existed 20 and 25 years ago. And how Brian Chesky, who co-founded Airbnb disrupted big hospitality brands like, and this guy tweets questions on products and services, and he builds relationships with his Airbnb's users through Twitter, you know. And this guy like earned thousands of followers, and he disrupted, and he built a multi-billion dollar company, you know, through Instagram, through Twitter, you know. And mm-hmm. another great example is Travis Kalanick, who founded Uber. And Uber, this guy Travis hired the first product manager through Twitter, and this former product manager is now a billionaire. And this is a great example to what extent social media helped hungry entrepreneurs build like a multi-billion dollar companies. And we are not talking about multi-million dollar companies. We are talking about multi-billion dollar companies, you know. And you are also connected with everyone on Twitter, and you see what extent these people achieved success in the last 10 years, right? So why should not business schools teach contemporary practical marketing strategies to their students and to help them to stay relevant in the age of automation and the age of disruption, right? My question is, why don't students deserve to build their personal brand on social media and not to share their duck pics on Instagram or on Snapchat or something, right? Why everyone deserves a chance to build their personal brand in order to build a multi-million dollar companies at the age of 20, 21, 22, because people should strike while the iron is hot, and when the golden era of social media will be over, they will miss this chance. And you know, and I tell my clients that if they don't put out content across 8-10 social networks, they will regret not putting out more content in 2035, 15 years later, they will regret, you know. And right. And we all know that when it was a golden era of MySpace, some people neglected Facebook, and those people lost, you know. And I mean, there are so many examples that we need to win attention in every social network that dominates the screen, period. There is no doubt about that, you know. And it is confusing for me. It is baffling. It is mystifying for me why business schools don't focus on practical marketing strategies, and they existed, and they teach strategies like Nike's 1985 billboard strategy. Who is interested? Who is interested in Nike's or Adidas 1985 billboard strategies? Right? We live in a mobile first world, Diane. We live in a mobile first world, and as Gary Vaynerchuk said, mobile became TV, and TV became radio. Right? So we transitioned from radio to TV, and from TV to mobile. Right? So everyone's attention is nowadays on mobile devices. So, but as I see, people are still stuck in a TV mentality, and they don't want to download this Twitter, Instagram, LinkedIn, Tumblr, TikTok, and other social media networks that can help them to impact their business and grow them faster. You know, it is very, but people who take risks, people who take risks and who say yes to new things, they win. They triple and quadruple their results, and we are very grateful to have hungry and voracious entrepreneurs in our industry who put out more content, who provide value, and who speak at conferences to share their practical marketing and social media strategies with us, to inspire us also to become practitioners, to build our business from home. And we need nobody's green light in 2020 to be successful, and we don't need like a Harvard MBA to stand out, you know, because everything is available at our fingertips. And if people recognize what is available at their fingertips, they know that it takes $0. It takes $0 to open a Gmail account. It takes $0 to sign up LinkedIn. It takes $0 to start tweeting. It takes $0 to create blog posts on WordPress or Tumblr or Medium, right? So As you know, that this opportunity did not exist 20 and 25 years ago, and it used to cost fortune to reach global audiences, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and you brought up some really good points there about, you know, Nike, Adidas, and some of the things that they that made them successful. And I teach a lot of marketing still, and leadership and business in different courses. And in some of the courses they have, you were saying about business schools and what they're teaching. And it's interesting how much we've, I know at some of my schools, we have Twitter feeds right in the class. We try to, instead of sticking with maybe Enron, we're talking about Theranos and some of the newer issues. And I know that we talk about, I actually get them following, like when Gillette had their ad that freaked out everybody on Twitter, you know, I have them follow that kind of stuff. And I think that it's really important that we do. I agree with you that it's so important to keep up with the latest things. But you know, you mentioned looking at what the next Facebook is, that you may be hanging on to MySpace without recognizing the value of Facebook. What do you think? I know there's a lot of discussion about TikTok and some of the things, you know, they may or may not want certain companies in the US, but what do you think is the next big, I mean, of course, Facebook's obviously huge, and Twitter and LinkedIn and some of those. But do you foresee that something could take over in those spaces, or do you think we'll just see something in addition to them?
Diane, first of all, I can't predict anything because I market in the year actually we live in. But
right.
What I see in the future is that voice technology will dominate this decade. Actually,
voice?
To what extent we use voice? Yes. Mm-hmm. To what extent we use voice technology, which actually voice is a time saver. So
right.
Which allows us to save time and simultaneously we do other things, you know? So mm-hmm. Voice is a big time saver. I mean, to what extent we use Alexa and Google Home at our home, it helps us save time, right? Mm-hmm. So also what I see that commerce is integrated into Pinterest and Instagram and Facebook too. So
mm-hmm.
So also augmented reality will impact marketing, and also 5G will also impact marketing, but we need to focus, you know. I mean sometimes it's not practical to talk about AI and IoT all the time, because we need to focus more on practicality, what is available at our fingertips, and through practical social media strategies, we can start building multi-million dollar company today, right? So,
right.
I mean, why everyone should put out like 100 pieces of content, like across 8-10 social networks, right? For example, Facebook, right? And other mm-hmm. networks. Facebook, Instagram, Tumblr, LinkedIn. I mean, everyone can start building. I became a member of Senior Council in March. You know, they will count me as a member. I will became a member with IoT Council. You know, I also became a speaker. I mean, I started joining speakers bureaus in May, and now I am a speaker with almost 20 speakers bureaus throughout the world, and they ask me to send them like a keynote topics and. My biography, my awards, my photos, and I'm so thankful, Diane, that they appreciate my hard work, you know.
Uh-huh.
And I'm just grateful, you know. I'm now 33 years old, and I'm probably the youngest person on the influencers list, because the majority of influencers are much older than me, you know. So I started building my social media networks in 2014 when I was 27 years old. So I envisaged, you know, where the world was going, and I started going in that direction, you know. Mm-hmm. So it paid off, Diane. It paid off, because whatever I achieved, my results always speaks for themselves. And having 125,000 followers, sometimes I can't believe, and I always I demand more from myself, you know, to achieve more, you know, to because I track my progress every single day. For example, I have been tracking my social media growth since 2014, from month to month, how many more followers I have in this month. Have my influencer scores increased in this month, you know, and I totally I totally, social media impacted my journey, you know? And I think everyone can achieve the same, you know? And everyone should be, and during this pandemic crisis and like COVID-19, negativity is over because so many people are unemployed and so many people are worried about the future, what will be in the future. And when I see that they are due to start organizing events from May 2021, right? I mean, it's not easy. It's not easy, Diane, to be. It's very easy to be pessimistic, but it's very hard to be optimistic, Ryan. And if people choose optimism and the positivity, they know that in the long run they will win. You know, if they start putting out more content and everyone should show more interest, Diane. Everyone should show more curiosity. Why these networks exist and why they are godsend for our business and entrepreneurial journey starts through Twitter. My journey show that demonstrates this example that entrepreneurial journey starts with Twitter, period. There is no doubt about that, you know, and I'm so proud to have organic growth, Diane, you know, and organic winning attention across 8-10 social networks is the best thing anyone can do. And Diane, there are two kinds of attention nowadays, you know, there are two kinds of attention, underpriced attention and overpriced attention. And I have grown my social media networks organically, you know, and I have not paid any dollars on advertising myself on Facebook, even on Instagram or even LinkedIn, because I have gained everything through my hard work, through putting out content, Diane, through creating blog posts, through putting out slideshows, PowerPoint presentations, and all kinds of content, because content is number one key to success, Diane, everyone. There is no doubt at all about that. And even Gary Vaynerchuk puts out so many content such extent. I mean, Evan Kistel, everyone knows who is Evan Kistel is. Everyone knows, everyone is inspired by Marsha Collier, who is our great colleague. And like Gordon Treadgold is a fantastic pioneer in leadership. And I think our industry is very grateful to have such people who share their blog posts, who share their insights, who share their thoughts with us. And I'm also a product of discipline, of curiosity, of self-esteem, and persistence, Diane. And without these qualities, I would not have achieved anything. And I have been lucky to have surrounded myself with right people at the right time, at the right time with right people, you know, and who inspired me to put in the work and to become who I am today. And I'm very grateful from the bottom of my heart for everything I have in this decade in 2020. And I always believe in giving back to society, to my followers, and I always provide value. And I have nothing to sell, you know. I can only sell my expertise at conferences, at speakers bureaus, and at such events, you know. But on Twitter, on LinkedIn, on Facebook, on Instagram, I put out content that is in my followers' best interest, not in my best interest, you know, which allowed me to build my personal brand to such extent. And well, you know, it is amazing that I see nowadays that more and more people are more sales oriented people, and only maybe 2% are like brand builders and marketers. And this brand building is very important, Diane. Brand building and salespeople struggle to build their personal brands because they always selling on social media. And every time I connect with someone on LinkedIn, they send me their pitch and whatever they sell, and I'm tired sometimes of interacting with such people. No, they want to, first of all, to provide value, you know. They should give and then ask something. And initially they from the outset they ask, not provide value, not give, you know. And giving is number one key to success, not ask. And asking is number one number one way to fail in 2020, you know? So I think people should differentiate, you know, what is giving and what is asking, you know? And givers always win more, Diane, than takers, you know? I see so many more people say looking forward to taking. I'm tired. You need to give first before you win something, before you ask for something, before you... I mean, I connected with someone today, and someone never said hi or something, and he asks me, Diane, to like his LinkedIn page, you know, or LinkedIn company's page. I mean, sometimes, you know, I don't want to interact with such people, because first of all, you need to like some contents, like say thank you, say something grateful, great to build a relationship before you ask me to like your company's page or something, not acceptable for me, Diane, because we know to what extent on Twitter we build a relationship, because it is like a family. It's like a Twitter is like a cocktail party for business world, you know, because everyone knows everyone, everyone retweets everyone, everyone supports others, you know, and they support each other. But on LinkedIn, it is sometimes very hard to build authentic relationship because they focus on selling, Diane, you know, so.
That's interesting that you see.
If you see people like Jay Shetty, Gary Vaynerchuk, like Simon Sinek, and other outstanding and amazing thought leaders, they always provide value. They are brand builders. They provide content that is in their followers' best interest. They provide motivational quotes. They provide blog posts. And I think if conferences and summits pay those thought leaders $200,000 for each conference, they pay them because they deserve, because they have done so much for their followers on social media, and their insight and their thoughts inspired others to build multi-million-dollar companies, Diane.
Well, you brought up some really good points. And I think that, you know, on Twitter, it is a different kind of conversation than it is on LinkedIn and some of that. And I was just curious, I was looking at your Twitter account, and I know you share a lot of content from a lot of different sources. So I'm curious how you find your content, and I'm wondering how much time you spend a day on Twitter. Are you using anything like Hootsuite or like Meet Edgar or something?
No. I don't. Yeah. Diane, I don't use Hootsuite or Buffer or like such social media listening platforms. I have built my Twitter organically, Diane. I never spend any dollars on advertising, or I never asked anyone to follow me. People followed me because I provide content. I put out content that is inspiring, that is motivating. Is that
how much time do you spend finding that?
We have 24 hours a day, and probably I spend around maybe 7-8 hours on Twitter a day.
7 to 8 hours a day on Twitter? Wow, yes. That's a lot.
Diane, that is a big responsibility for me to have 57,000 followers on Twitter, and it is a big duty. Believe me, it is a big responsibility for me to have 57,000 followers, and 57,000 people expect motivational, inspiring, and informative posts. You know, informative tweets, and
Where do you get your information? Then I'm curious. I don't mean to interrupt.
I spend so much time on research, Diane. You know, I spend so much time on research. I'm inspired by everyone, Diane. I'm inspired by how people built multi-billion-dollar companies. Like, I'm inspired by Gary Vaynerchuk. I inspired by Jack Ma. I inspired by Simon Sinek. I'm inspired by. I mean, Henry Ford and other giant, Elon Musk, and these outstanding leaders show great examples how they should build businesses, and how they should be optimistic, and how they should neglect noise around them, and how they should choose positivity, optimism, and kindness. Because choosing kindness is very hard, Diane, you know, because you need to keep focusing on positivity all the time, you know, and And there are many factors. There are many factors in this world to stop us, you know, from succeeding. But we need to keep going, Diane. We need to keep pushing. We need to keep, to keep going and to keep chasing our goals and dreams, you know. So I'm as you mentioned, I build my Twitter. I also build my LinkedIn, Instagram, Facebook. I build my TikTok, Snapchat, Medium, and I mean, having totally 125,000 followers, and I think my hard work truly paid off in the last 10 years that I pushed to grow my personal brand and to provide value and to build a relationship with my audience. And I think being grateful, being thankful, being kind towards your tribe community is number one key to success. And I always say thanks to everyone, you know, when they retweet me, when they like or comment my tweets, you know. And also across other social media networks, I always show gratitude. And if I have 31 recommendations on LinkedIn nowadays, I have these 31 recommendations because I have earned these recommendations by deed of my hard work, Diane. And truly, Twitter helped me to earn those recommendations on LinkedIn because, as you know, it is a fierce competition on LinkedIn, and everyone competes, and everyone, you know, it's very more competitive network, you know, on LinkedIn. But on Twitter, right, people are more opposite, you know. It is like a cocktail party. It is much easier to join conversation, to engage in conversation, to say hi, and to build a relationship with your audience. And when there is a will, there is a way. You need to strike while the iron is hot. You need to build your Twitter. You need to build other social media networks, because just mark my words, when the golden era of social media will be over, people will regret Diet, you know. And what we do on now mobile devices, we will do everything on voice assistance, Diane, in the next few years, you know. And so I think we will transition from mobile to voice world, you know, because, you know, things change like grease lighting, and these new trends like AI, machine learning, and IoT, and this VR and AR and mixed reality impact marketing tremendously, Diane.
Well, you know, as you talk about all this, I remember watching one of your videos, and you were talking about how people can share insights on social media. And you said it takes curiosity to download and share these things. But you said some people are scared of that. For somebody who's scared of this, in our final question here, just like how do you get over the fear of getting into a negative conversation on a social media site? How do you deal with the negativity? Because there's a lot of haters that like to say.
Yes, Diane, I have coped with negativity on Twitter. You know, mm-hmm. I simply neglecting those.
Avoid responding.
Yes, I don't engage in nonsense with people. You know, I don't have time. You know.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. That is one of the
big things. Everyone should do that. You know. Because there are always people dying on social media who are doubters and who are, skeptics, you know. So and there is no point in like spending time to convince others who you are, you know. And I think it is a waste of time for me to spend time in nonsense with other people. Of course, you know. I have blocked so many people on Twitter because, you know, when you have 57,000 followers, you expect people to come to your profile and to spit venom, you know. So I think, but I'm not that kind of person who does the same, you know. It's much opposite. I always inspire, motivate, and to encourage others to achieve more, because there is always a great chance to succeed, and everyone can win in 2020. And I mean, life is short, you know, and life is short for grudges and for tit for tat or something like that, right? So
right. Well,
I think all thought leaders we see right nowadays on Twitter, right? Marsha Collier, Evan Kestel, I mean, Brian Solis, I mean, they are optimist people, you know, they are optimistic, they are positive people, they are kind people, they are very driven to help others succeed. And I'm very thankful to Brian, and Brian is one of my inspiration in marketing and innovation, alongside Gary Vaynerchuk, Simon Sinek, and other people, and people on Twitter who have 200 followers, and we expect sometimes them to be negative and to say something bad or in the comments or something, but there is no point in attacking them back, you know, Diane, because I'm not that kind of person who attacks them back or I mean, of course, you know, it's very bad when we experience something like that, but you know what we should do? I mean, to spend time to attack them back, or we should continue to inspire our community, and because we need to be grateful if we have 57,000 followers and they stand with us and they encourage us, and we are always in this journey together, you know?
Yeah, and I think that's a great place to stop, because I think that really there's so much we can learn from all the things that you work on. And I think a lot of people will want to know, obviously you're on Twitter, but in some of these other social media platforms, where's the best place to reach you? Do you want to share some way that they could find you?
Where people can find me on social media?
Yes, like on Twitter. I know you go by Dr.
Yes, they can also find me on Instagram, on LinkedIn, on Facebook, by my name, Vladimer Botsvadze. Uh-huh. And I'm also on other social networks like Snapchat, TikTok. Also on Medium, and I provide value across 15-20 social media networks, Diane, and this has been the driving force behind my growth, and providing content has been instrumental in my growth, you know.
Well, I know you do a lot, and I think a lot of my students and a lot of the people who listen to the show and everybody who's been confused about where's the best place to, you know, connect and how to do it could learn a lot from you. So thank you.
Okay,
so
Diane, I will tell you a few networks. For example, Facebook is still far and away the most popular social media platform.
Right.
It boasts 2.6 billion worldwide users. Facebook Facebook is good for local brick and mortar stores, nonprofits, B2B companies. LinkedIn is a professional driven platform. It is best for link clicks and event registrations, good for luxury brands and services, software providers, and B2B companies. Instagram is a powerful brand building platform. You need to have lots of high quality images and videos to support this platform. It is the best for word of mouth awareness and engagement. As everyone knows, Twitter is a fast moving, real time, news driven platform. A strong customer service element. Be prepared to engage and respond customers there. It is the best for link clicks and engagement. Pinterest is the best used for companies that provide products and services to a female audience. The platform thrives off posting and reposting images to boards, and you will need lots of quality content. Tumblr is a best place for artists to show off their work, and this platform is very art and blogging focused, you know. If your audience is interested in art of blogging, Tumblr might be right for your business. Brands should leverage Snapchat geo filters and sponsored lenses to create interactive content. TikTok has 800 million users worldwide, and with majority of them aged between 16 and 24 years old. Users share videos and bound to be successful on TikTok. And users share videos and ranging from 15 to 16 seconds in length. Brands that create original create videos are bound to be successful on TikTok. And everyone should start small and they should not try to go viral with their first post. Influencers determine what is current and will garner the most views. People find influencers to be relatable, which stops brands from being viewed is as overly sales oriented, you know, oriented. Right.
Well, I think that those are all really good tips. And I think that a lot of people could learn a lot from you. So I hope they take some time to check out you, your sites, and everything that you do. Thank you so much for being on the show, Vladimer. This was very interesting.
Thank you very much, Diane. And thanks for allowing me to share my journey, experience, know-how, and every insights with your audience. And I hope that everyone will benefit from my journey, and everyone will recognize to what extent powerful social networks are available at their fingertips, and they should push more positivity, optimism, kindness, and when there is a will, there is a way. And everyone should put out like 100 pieces of content at scale every single day across 8-10 social media networks. And entrepreneurial journey starts with Twitter, starts with Instagram, starts with LinkedIn, starts with Facebook. And if we see successful thought leaders like Gary Vaynerchuk, like Simon Sinek, like Jay Shetty, and other top social media influencers, they also started from zero followers, and they showed persistence, they showed kindness, they showed positivity and the discipline and persistence to build their businesses and build their tribes. And everyone should do the same, and always stay outside your comfort zone and explore more. Everyone should strike while the iron is hot, and everyone will be proud of their efforts finally.
Yeah, I think those are great words of wisdom. And we will be back right after this message.
Do you know someone who might benefit from taking the Curiosity Code Index assessment? The CCI is the first and only assessment that determines the factors that inhibit curiosity. It's simple. If you recommend the assessment to someone else, you can receive 20% of the purchase price that they pay when they take the CCI through the link provided by you. To obtain the link and become an affiliate, please go to drdianehamilton.com/affiliate. Well, I'd really like to thank Vladimer for being my guest today. We get so many great guests on this show. If you've missed any past episodes, you can catch them at drdianehamilton.com. You can go to the blog and read about them. And I'd love to hear from you. So we have tweetable moments on there. If you find something you really found fascinating, please tweet them out. And we'd love to get the conversation going. And I really hope you enjoyed today's episode, and I hope you join us for the next episode of Take the Lead Radio. You've been listening to Take the Lead with Dr. Diane Hamilton on C-Suite Radio.